Hello, this is my first video that I'm going to upload. I think it's understandable. I'll explain it as I go. What I'd like to talk about today and present to everyone is what's called the electromagnetic radiation spectrum, of which light itself, visible light, is a small part of. And as you'll see on my wall, I'll go through it all and explain it. Visible light goes from what we can see, which is one end, the red light, going through your orange light, then yellow light, then green light, then blue light, then violet light. And as you can see on my wall here, visible light are all the rainbow colours, which is seen in white light. And if you pass it through the atmosphere and there's moisture, it acts like a prism because of the water molecules, and splits it up into its components, which is red light, orange light, yellow light, green light, blue light, and violet light, as you can see here. And there, the visible spectrum of light or electromagnetic radiation, right? And we see it as white light normally, coming from the sun and stars and other sources. Now that's just a small part of the electromagnetic spectrum. It starts at the farther end, which is radio waves. We all know what radio waves are. We communicate with them, we listen to the radio. We have radio waves for the TV frequencies and whatever. Then we have microwaves, which is how mobile phones communicate these days, the signals. And also microwaves are used in microwave ovens for cooking. The water molecules in our food absorb the microwaves and it makes them vibrate, which generates heat, and that's what cooks the food. And then we have what we would normally perceive as heat. What we call heat is infrared radiation. Heat, infrared radiation. We can't see it, but we do see its near companion, red light. When there's red light, often there's sources of infrared radiation, which is invisible. We can't see it, and that's what heat is. And things that cause heat or infrared radiation are like fires, gas stoves, matches, lighters, anything that burns gives off heat. Plus heat is given off in the centre of stars, where fusion, nuclear fusion, takes place. I'll explain about that in a later video. And other sources, friction, compression of gas causes heat as well. Motion causes heat, causes friction and that. And then we move to visible light again. We have the red light, yellow light, blue light, violet. That's part of the visible electromagnetic spectrum, visible light. But we see it all combined normally as white light. Then we have ultraviolet light. Sources of ultraviolet light are things like our sun, stars. It's invisible to our eyes, but insects, many insects can see it, such as bees and whatnot. And they use it to find plants and flowers so they can gather nectar and pollen and whatever that give off or fluoresce in ultraviolet light. That's invisible. And then we move to x-rays. X-rays are given off by radioactive chemical elements on the periodic table, nuclear reactions, and basically sources such as stars that are massive enough that when they come to the final stages of their life, the core collapses and can form neutron stars, which is a source of X-rays. I'll explain about that in a different video later on. Then we have gamma rays. Gamma rays come from much more energetic sources, such as the formation of black holes from sources such as supernova of massive stars. When the end of the nuclear fusion process reaches its critical point and it can no longer support itself, the core can't support itself with nuclear reactions of fusion, and it collapses in a catastrophic implosion forming black holes, and that gives off gamma rays. Now, what do I talk about when we've the electromagnetic spectrum? At this end of the electromagnetic spectrum, we have the radio waves, microwaves, infrared, red, which is the visible light going through to violet, and so on. It's lower frequency as you get further along in the electromagnetic spectrum, the frequency increases. And starting at the radio wave and microwave end of the spectrum, the wavelength is longer of the electromagnetic spectrum radiations. When we talk about wavelength, we're talking about peak of the wave. This is a wave with peaks and troughs. That's what a wave is. Peak to peak is one wavelength, or trough to trough, trough to trough is one wavelength. That's wavelength. Peak to peak or trough to trough. If you think about it like this, if you think about waves, say you drop an object like a stone in a pond, it generates waves and it spreads out across the water, and it's ripples. Or you go to the beach and you see waves coming ashore. These are what's called longitudinal waves, if I remember correctly. And they have peaks and they have troughs. And if you think about waves in a pond or waves on the ocean, at one point the water is high, and then at one point the water is low, then it's high, then it's low. That's the peaks and troughs. That's how you think about that. Now, the equation of the electromagnetic spectrum, or waves, what that refers to, wavelength is referred to, the symbol for wavelength is the Greek letter lambda, L-A-M-B-D-A. That's the symbol for lambda. It's kind of like an upside down Y. That's what wavelength is. That's measured in, usually meters is a standard thing, but we work in centimeters at the moment. And then you have frequency. For example, frequency of sound waves, which is the same principle, peaks and troughs, like waves or ripples on a pond or in the ocean, is measured in hertz. That's frequency is number of waves, which is one wavelength, per period of time. I think that's right. I need to research that. I will be talking about that later. I'll be going into all this much more depth later. Now, the speed of a wave is constant. and that's V for velocity, speed. And that equals, in the electromagnetic spectrum, or the electromagnetic radiation spectrum, including visible light and everything I've been talking about, 186,000 miles per second, or 3 times 10 to the 8, that's 3 with 8 zeros after it, meters per second. The B minus 1 just means per second, meters per second, 3 times 10 to the 8 meters per second. The way you work out the different components of this formula, you draw a triangle. I've chopped the top of the triangle off, unfortunately, but you draw a triangle, and then you draw a line roughly through the middle of the triangle, and then a rough line from the middle of that section, the bottom of it, down, cutting the bottom section of the triangle in two equal parts, and then you put the value V, which is the speed of the wave, which is constant, and equals frequency in this bottom left hand section times wavelength, lambda, in centimeters. I hope everyone enjoyed that. If you have any questions, next week I'll put some values in for what the wavelength and frequency of radio waves to microwaves, infrared, visible light, and ultraviolet, X-rays and gamma rays. Going back to ultraviolet, you might have heard the UVA and UVB. They're just different wavelengths and frequencies of a small portion of ultraviolet light. They both come from sources like the sun, our star, and I can't remember which, but UVA or UVB we need to put sun cream on to protect us from, because it damages skin over time. But the other UV light that we need, I can't remember which, A or B, is good for us. It helps us make vitamin D in the skin, which keeps us healthier. Vitamin D, that's why we need as much sunlight as we can, or in some cases, vitamin D tablets. So if anyone needs anything explained or has any questions, just contact me through Gwen at Health and Mind through an email. I'll be uploading this video, and I'm a bit nervous about my first presentation. I hope it all was made sense and was interesting. And if anyone has any questions, they can get back to me. I hope everyone enjoyed and liked this video. Thank you. Bye and take care. Hello, this is a short update on my first physics upload. I thought I got it wrong. I mixed up longitudinal waves with transverse waves. Transverse waves are light and the electromagnetic spectrum. Longitudinal waves are sound, ultrasound, like in ultrasound scanners and whatnot, and seismic waves that move through the earth. They're generated by tectonic plates and earthquakes and stuff like that, or impacting objects on the surface of the earth and things like that. Yeah, that's what longitudinal waves are. It's the difference between movement of the medium the wave is is moving through, and motion of the wave as well, that sort of thing. Yeah. I'll explain more about that later. I'll review that and go through it and explain it properly, the difference between the two. I hope everyone enjoyed the video. Thank you. Hello, this is a briefing about my upcoming video. It's about waves and the different types of waves and what happens as they move through atmospheres, solid objects, liquid objects, and also what happens with waves as they pass through a vacuum. And as a sideline to that, I'll go back to, if you remember, heat, infrared radiation, and I'll demonstrate how a vacuum prevents heat from escaping from a liquid such as tea or coffee, hot or cold, keeps it at the same temperature for a long time, because it prevents convection, which is the escape of heat through materials. I'll draw a diagram of how a vacuum flask or thermos flask is designed, and explain how the vacuum between the inner flask and the outer surface of the flask prevents the escape of heat and keeps the tea, coffee, whatever, hot chocolate, hot, or keeps liquids cold and prevents heat getting in to heat the liquid up. And for the propagation and properties of longitudinal waves and sound waves I mentioned, you'll need, for a wee experiment to demonstrate it, you will need something like two empty washed and dried pot noodle pots, or any kind of noodle pots, like a pot noodle. You'll need some string or wool, and you'll need a small pair of scissors or a small star or Phillips screwdriver, a small one, to puncture a small hole in the centre of the bottom of the pot noodle pots. And I'll show you how to put it all together and demonstrate the property of propagation of sound waves through vibration and transmission, and also the other property, what was it again? I'll get back to that, I need to think. I'm a bit tired and I'm forgetting things. But I hope you find it interesting.